And a good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the McLean Broadcast Network. Tonight, your McLean Highlanders varsity ice hockey team is taking on the Flint Hill Huskies here in the NVSHL action. Tonight, the 7-0 McLean Highlanders will be looking to clinch the Adams Division Championship against Flint Hill. A very exciting game for you as McLean is looking to try to go for only the second time to the state championship game. Will they be able to clinch tonight? That is the big question on everybody's mind here. Their opponents, the Flint Hill Huskies, come in with 3 wins, 3 losses, and 1 tie. McLean looking to shut them down early. That is the reference that Coach Sherlock has used. We are filling up here fast here at Skate Quest out here in Reston, Virginia for this one. A good amount of fans from both schools coming here, so it should be a very electric atmosphere for this huge game tonight, as well as many parents from both teams. We are live across from the benches here within the spectators fan, within the seats here at Skate Quest, so this should be a very exciting action here as we get a great view of the game tonight. The normal starting goaltender, Josh Cowson, is not in net. He is being replaced by Tori Yoon here as Coach Sherlock looks to get Tori some experience. He believes that his team can still win even with their backup goaltender. And Tori, he's done good. He's still helped the team. It isn't that big of a difference. Both are experienced goaltenders. This entire team is of upperclassmen. There are a total of 8 seniors on this McLean varsity ice hockey team. Team, this is a radio podcast of the game tonight. We cannot bring you a camera as usual, but we should be working on that, hopefully, in time for next year's football season. But regardless, we have a hockey game to play tonight. Now, the NVSHL, Northern Virginia Scholastic Hockey League, is not affiliated with any of the local counties. None of the teams are school sports. Unfortunately, because there are some great fans and great players, they don't receive varsity letters. They're basically playing because they love the game. And that really is special for both of these teams, and really makes the reason not about fame and more about just having fun and playing. We're going to step aside here when we come back, the opening face-off here, and what should be a very exciting game. You're listening to your only home for McLean sports here on the McLean Broadcast Network. We'll mute our mics, and we will see you in about 1 minute. And welcome back to McLean Broadcast Network. I'm Matthew Zwirb with you as both teams are taking the center ice for the faceoff circle. It'll be Chris Cardwell out for McLean to take the draw. The opening draw, McLean and Flint Hill. Here we go. We are underway. Flint Hill wins the draw, and they'll send it off the near boards and back of McLean. And Aiden Fisk will take it up. Now goes to the center and poked away by number 19 of the Flint Hill Huskies. Or 18, that'll be Wheeler, excuse me. But then a turnover, and coming in is Chris Cardwell. He'll get smashed off on the near half wall and thrown behind the net. Huskies trying to take over, and they will. Still in their own zone. Huskies moving it up, but falls down. Aiden Phipps trying to smash it into the zone, but pass goes nowhere, and Flint Hill will take it. Now here Flint Hill, they're having it. Number 99 here for Flint Hill, trying to throw it out front, and Ebenhart will take over on the far boards, but turned over now. Here comes Colton Hoipel, who gets to Dev. Dev here with a quick shot, and that went off the glass. Headed over, and McLean and Malloy will take over. McLean still having it down low, trying to centering feed to Dev, and that one goes off. Out of play. Now here, Hoipel, Colton, trying to get it in. Stick goes flying near the near boards, gets it to Fipwa. Biff Waugh, very talented player, only a few goals this season. Very disappointing for him. Now Biff Waugh trying to go around his man here in the left circle. Back to a point where a shot for Carter Gross has save made. Going 5-0 on the goalie, that would be Morris. 13:28 to go, no score with you here at Skate Quest. Faceoff will be to the left of Morse. Holden Hoipo take it. Doesn't quite win it cleanly, but Tommy Malloy has it over on the left point. He'll backhand. He had left wing corner. McLean takes over. Line strike. Gets around man, centering feet. The Hoipo here with a quick shot, and that one deflects to the glass. And Flint Hill trying to take over. McLean playing pretty well, being able to keep the putts in as it deflects, as it bounces around, but finally settled down. Tommy Malloy will take over. Getting it up ahead. Stroy trying to get it, and he gets it to Wah. Wah working left circle. Wah around the net. Biff Wah looking, circling, but a shot, and that hits somebody in front. And it'll be played to the right wing corner and trying to send out. Looking here, Colton Hoipo trying to cut to the center, but it's taken over. And they'll dump it down, and this will go for icing. Flint Hill, Hill not able to get the puck out, and unfortunately having to ice it here with 12:31 to go here in the first period. So far, no score. Jake Barnett, he has David Todd to his left, Sam Silverman to his right. Here, take the draw. Once again, offensive zone faceoff for Highlanders. Which shot deflected to the left corner, left wing corner by David Todd. And then Flint Hill, and they'll try to take over. David Todd. Todd gets him to fire it down. No icing, but McLean will still have it. Aiden Phipps behind his own net, trying to work it out. Pressured by a Flint Hill player, and then he'll try to get it back, but it ends up coming out and back in safe hands of number 55. That would be Shane Ross for the Flint Hill Huskies. Buck running into a whole bunch of players. Flint Hill now with control. David Todd able to muscle his man off the putt. David Todd, a tremendous player for Highlanders. Not the type of player that you expect to do too much, but he's able to muscle guys off the puck and keep the puck. He is such a tremendous player, and another reason with so much depth why McLean able to play, be such a good team. Now, Dev DuVoyne out of his own zone. Dev coming in. Dev with a shot and save made. And that deflects almost out of the zone. And it will go on the carrium. Puck deflected back in behind the Flint Hill net. Now on the half wall on the right side, Dev able to muscle that one back, and it'll be carried by Stroy trying to get around. Puck goes to in front of the Flint Hill bench on the far side, and now that behind, Dev muscling his man all the way, and then carried on trying to catch the glass, catch the netting, and it's out of play. .10:49 to go, about four minutes gone. This game still no score between Flint Hill and McLean. McLean has four shots, Flint Hill has none. McLean, majority of possession time, really dominating this game, but Flint Hill does win a faceoff. But Biff Waugh now has it. Biff Waugh surveys the scene, finds Carl Groves, good puck movement by Highlands, trying to go. That's a Biff Waugh, where a shot and he misses. And he finds the glass. Carter Groves just sends it in behind. Colton Hoipo going down as he tried to get the puck by, ends up ringing and going off the, and he ends up taking off the net, so a whistle and faceoff will come out of the zone on the left near boards in front of the Flint Hill net, at least across from it. Faceoff here. One by the Highlanders. Carter Gross trying to get it to Aiden Phipps, but that one doesn't work. So he'll just play it back, a hard carry around, finding the Wah, and he gets ahead. Head here's a shot comes in by Colton Hoipo. just across the line in front of the left wing circle, face off in the left wing circle for McLean. To the right of the goaltender, Morris. Still no shots for the Flint Hill Huskies. McLean is the home team. After this, they still have a couple games. Two games left to go. Until the season's over. Flint Hill wins the faceoff by comes trying to get out of the zone. Tommy Malloy, a great save, then trying to throw it on net. And Dev DeVoyne will have it near on the left half while trying to center, trying to find Sam, and that one goes through everybody. And then Sam gets it back. Sam trying to centering feed to Dev. Won't work. He'll try to stick handle off. And here come Flint Hill. They have a man, number 14, number 19, Eberhardt. Won't work. And Sam Silverman will come up. 3-on-2, McLean hurry. Now Dev DeVoyne, they're going in, trying to centering feed out. Good on it. And they couldn't put it home. Sam Silverman. Pochettes gets it back. That's now to the point. Bruschutti sends it back. Now across. Dev still looking. Steph, left wing, trying to center feet. Doesn't get out, though. Malloy keeps in. He'll try to center back. Can't get it far enough. Malloy still battling on the half wall just inside. 9 minutes to go, and it's sent to the right wing corner. You got to love McLean's battle right now. Jordan Bloom then trying to get it back. It falls. Here with a shot from Suleiman for shooting in that one. Taken to the and out of the zone. Back in McLean's own zone. 8:37 to go. McLean with possession. They'll give it to David Todd. David Todd across the line. Trying to drop pass, going nowhere, and now it's a 2-on-2 the other way. McLean, though, able to swarm to the puck, nowhere near. Eberhardt went to the bench. He was the second man, and McLean will try to break it out. 8:14 to go. Aiden Phipps across the line. Phipps looking, trying to throw it to the front of the goal against David Todd. What a shot in that spot. Another shot from Phipps in that one. Won't go. McLean, 7 shots. The Flint Hills, none right now. Dominating play. They just need to get something to go. Phipps here with a shot, and that one deflected. David Todd trying to keep this one in. Won't be able to. It's deflected back into McLean's zone where Phipps will pick up. David Todd ahead to fifth wall versus speed. Almost taking out the rep there on the left wing side and going in for a hard hit. And then Phipps gives a low extra shove. No penalty called, but he needs to be careful as the puck all nearly out of the zone. Colton Hoipel dances around one man, takes a quick shot, and that's guided to the left wing corner. Phipps, and now working it. Now back to the point, trying to get it across. Finding Colton Hoipel, who'll circle and only sends it to a Flint Hill player who deflects it out of the zone. That would be number 15, Spivey for Flint Hill. Now versus speed. Wah, here with a shot in that one. Deflects out up and out of play with 6:49 to go. Still no score in this game. Appreciate that you are with us here on a really great after evening for hockey. It is cold outside, but it's nice and warm with jackets inside here. Face off outside of the zone near the far wall right in front of the Flint Hill net. Jordan Bloom trying to get in, won't be able to. It's deflected out and then almost turned over. Now it is Eberhardt and in, but offside. So the play will come back outside of the zone in front of the McLean bench. McLean, that was really their only. They made a couple mistakes giving the puck up to Flint Hill players, but they spent most of the time in their own zone. That in their offensive zone, excuse me. That is the good news. Sam Silverman to take the face off. And a false start by. No, they're going to make Eberhardt come off. And on comes number 22, Cargis. Malloy winning the faceoff. They'll get it off to Jordan Bloom. Jordan Bloom versus speed, takes it wide. Looking, surveys his options. Goes left wing corner, spin move cut off there. Now back to the point. Point across, Tommy Malloy. Makes a man miss, falls down, and nearly gave that one away. Wait, but Cargrove's able to get back in time. Shot comes in and wide, and they will curl ahead. Once again, Jordan Bloom is two on two. Dev DuVoin, the trailer, they'll give it to DuVoin with a shot, and that one just nearly wide, trying to get it back here, and they do. Now here's Sam Silverman. Silverman gets hit hard by number 77 of the Flint Hill Huskies. I do not have a name for him, unfortunately, but that is all right. Puck back behind the McLean net is Carter Gross, 5:36 to go. He'll send ahead to Jordan Bloom. That's deflected away from him, and then Flint Hill will carry up ahead. Number 14, he'll get it to number. Hill again, I do not have numbers for them. They did have a small varsity team, so I wondered, I'm sure that they call many people up for this game. Colton Hoyfel ahead, getting it. Hoyfel able to play it out, but isn't able to get to the puck, unfortunately. But he'll take it here. Colton Hoyfel. Pip Watt got tangled up now. Colton Hoyfel with a shot. That's deflected. Gets it to Colton Hoyfel. Left wing circle trying to go around. Won't be able to. Off the glass. Trying to get out. Won't be able to. Pip Watt working. Pip Watt sends it to Colton Hoyfel. McLean needs some puck movement here. Colton Hoyfel trying to get to the slot. Take it down. Delay penalty. The Highlanders are going to have a power play. That's your point. Aiden Phipps, one timer, but no one out in front. Kind of surprised that he did take that shot. And the Highlanders are going to be on the power play. It's going to be a two-man mine for tripping on number 12. I believe that will be Daniel Dooley, one of the Dooley brothers. No, excuse me, it won't be. Cannot see the number. Believe it is number 19. I do not have a name for him. I do apologize. Face off. Won by Flint Hill. They'll send it down. In behind. Tor Yoon. Playing it. Just sending it behind him. McLean will try to set up. Carter Gross. Almost lost the puck, but didn't. McLean now trying to break it out. Jordan Bloom, perfect pass. Jordan Bloom on the wall, spin move, looking, 1:35 to go on power play, sends it across. Now we have a fifth right front. Same rebound, Jordan can't get there and sent away. Oh my goodness. And now out back and sent towards the net, and it'll be a cover up with 3:36 to go. 8 shots for the Highlanders to none, and they are looking good thus far in this game. And unfortunately, we have an injury. Chris Cardwell looks to be having some form of shore problem, and he is going to the locker room, and that's a big loss for this team, the captain. And we hope he's okay. You don't, at this time of season, playoffs coming up in a couple weeks, you need to be healthy. And you always worry anytime a player gets injured. Bipwah behind the net. Bipwah looking, sends it to Aiden Phipps. Nobody in front. Now here's Sam, and he tries centering feet. Doesn't work coming to the near boards. And sent down, and Jay Barnett's going to get a hooking call. He doesn't like it. Either way, it's going to be 4-on-4 for the next 49 seconds. The Flint Hill player went down. Jay Barnett claiming that he didn't do anything. but unfortunately, it's 4-4. McLean just lost their power play. 41 seconds go in Flint Hills penalty. It's 2 minutes on the clock. The clock has not started, so not sure what's going on with this. It right now says 2:54, but McLean can keep playing. Jordan Bloom now they finally get the clock rolling. 2:50 to go in the period. Jordan Bloom, here goes Jordan Bloom. A shot that's off the post. Jordan Bloom came in all alone. What a move by Jordan Bloom. Now back to a point, 8 and 5. And now this is Uman with a shot that's deflected to the right wing corner. Dev there on it. Poked away and out of the zone by fifth by Flint Hill. And that will go for an ice. Now they say 11 seconds on the clock. I don't know when Jake Barnett will be released from the penalty box. They finally put it up. They're saying 1:30. That is the time that remains. So it will be just over. Well, now they're letting the clock run a little bit. And Flint Hill will have a power play. 2:11 go in the first period, still no score. Flint Hill on the attack on the power play, but McLean still having it. Tommy Malloy dishes it carefully back behind the net, picked up, and then trying to send out. He only finds Malloy's stick, though, and it will be sent on net. Good idea for the Highlanders. 1:50 to go. McLean still trying to get a goal here, and here comes Ebenhardt. Ebenhardt moving to the center of the ice away, and it'll come out of the zone, and that's good news for Highlanders, who only have 42 more seconds to kill. Jack Hecker trying to attack, but the play comes to Ebenhardt, but he won't be able to hang on. Tom Malloy takes it, fires it behind the net. 28 seconds to go on the power play, 1:20 to go in the period. Fired left wing corner and take it up. Ebenhardt looking, skates across the Skate Quest logo, plays it in. 11 seconds to go. No one really hard chasing for the Huskies, but then it's given up a shot in that one. Deflects off the post and out. Oh my goodness, a bad turnover for the Highlanders. Not something that they would want to do, and that could have been costly. Very lucky he's not 1-0 Flint Hill. No, and for McLean, you have to attack. The attack, again, we talked about McLean closing them down early. They have yet to do this, but here's a nice move. It's a 3-on-1 almost. Hoyfer with a shot, and that's right to the gut with 46.5 to go. Go, and, you know, if you're Hoyfer right there, you might want to just wait, seeing if some support comes. It's unfortunate that it was saved, but if you're Colton Hoyfel, you have to find a way to get a better shot off. Shooting it right to the gut won't do. Flint Hill wins the draw cleanly, but it's taken by Fibois. What a shot! Oh, man! And that just deflected off the shoulder of the goaltender, Morse. 35 seconds to go. Penalty is over. Out of the box is Jake Barnett. Now, Colton Hoyfel trying to go to the slot. He won't be able to. 27 seconds to go. Beats it to Phipps. Phipps playing it back to Fibois. Wah looking. Driving it up. Nothing's there. And now a whistle. And there's a whistle with 13.3 to go in the period. Not sure what this is about. Well, might have been played down with a high stick. Either way, the faceoff will stay in McLean's offensive zone, and there's going to be a penalty on fifth on Flint Hill. McLean's going to have a power play to start the second almost. 7-6 seconds to go. Now, Colton Hoyfel has to hurry. He'll just... And with a chance out front, ooh, and that as a shot from the point of the horn, Horton, and that almost handcuffed the goaltender. So after one, no score, McLean has 10 shots to at least one for Flint Hill. They don't have one, although, no, it went off the crossbar. That's why it does not count as a shot. But McLean, they've given up some big turnovers. And let's see what Coach Sherlock will tell them. As we go, we're going to step aside here, mute our mics. You're listening to McLean Broadcast Network. And welcome back to McLean Broadcast Network. It is currently we currently have no score here against the Flint Hill Huskies. McLean, by the way, will be going from left to right. Flint Hill going from right to left here in the second period. Still no score, although McLean's outshot Flint Hill 10 to nothing. That's what the shot count is on the scoreboard. McLean, they're going to start with a power play, start the second, see if the clock will be able to get all set here to start the second period. We will be picking up our basketball games next week. Obviously, Langley coming up in a few. We should have both the girls and boys games of the highly anticipated McLean-Langley showdown at McLean High School. Should be a very fun and exciting atmosphere. We also will be having all of McLean's varsity hockey playoff games for you. But that's okay. Now 15 minutes, periods in NVSHL, it's a bit shortened, just like all high school sports are. They had to get the time for the penalty up. They have yet to do that. So we are still awaiting the drop of the puck. For McLean, they really aren't feeling the best about themselves. Unfortunately, they weren't able to put anything home. They had some great chances here. 2 minutes of power play time is up on the board. Now they take it down, but I guess, well, no, either way, here comes Jordan Bloom trying to go in on net, and he, with a little bit of a snow shove to the goalie, I'm sure he didn't mean that, but either way, it's still... The goalie will save it, and the faceoff will be to the right of the goaltender, Morse. But the clock did not start on that play. It still shows 15 minutes up on the board. We're having some big clock issues in this game now they're going to put 1:43 on the penalty and 14:57. And that should take on the game clock, and that should take care of everything. Based off one, Tommy Malloy now gets it, and a centering feed out for, oh, a save, rebound. Now the whistle went. Dev thought he had that. The pass came out in front to I believe, Aiden Phipps, who's shot. No, it might have been, Bershuti. Face off one. A ref and a player go tumbling down. And it's cleared back behind the McLean net. McLean picks it up. Feeds it over. And now it's Hoipel. Colton Hoipel crosses the line. Drop pass for Dev. Dev looking behind the net. Net harassed all the way by Flint Hill players. And now the Colton Hoipel trying to go to slot. Gets it back to Hoipel 2. He went a shot and that one goes wide. Oh, man, that almost was able to do something. Now centering feet to Dev DeVoyne. Trade out in front of the save. And how did he get it? My goodness. Colton Hoipel on the doorstep. And a blind eye robbery by Morse. Keeping his team in. He has 12 saves. But McLean's not able to put one on the board yet. Sam Silverman to take the face off. Missile Phelps and Phipp. So trying to change around some things, seeing if McLean's offense can get going. Plays it behind the net. Missile Phelps trying to read it, sent back and all the way down. 46 seconds to go on penalty. 13:57 to go in the second period. Here comes Fipwa looking across the line. Fipwa looking, and it's smashed back down by Evan Hart. Hart and a little bit of loveliness going there, but then a turnover over for McLean, not paying attention, but they're able to get it with 18 seconds to go on the penalty. McLean trying to bounce past the Fip, not able to take it, and it's sent off. 10 seconds to go, nearly a mistake. It's sent, now the missile fell for McLean. Fipwa across the line, Fipwa, big shot, no good. Probably not the best shooting angle for him. Him, 5-on-5 action now, penalty expires. Trying to centering pass to Fip. Evan Hart had none other, sits it away, and now he'll take it ahead. Played off the puck nicely by Fip. And sent back in. Flint Hill now trying to get it half wall, but McLean, as the pass out of zone didn't work, but Flint Hill will recover. Number 18 with it now for Flint Hill. They'll move ahead, but off of the stick of the intended man, and it'll be sent ahead, and now we have a whistle. Not sure if there's a penalty. I believe it might be on. Is it an offsides call? What's the deal? There's a bit of an argument going on, or at least a discussion. With 12:28 to go. Not sure what this is about. High stick, or is there a power play, or there's a whistle that was going and. Well, there's going to be a wait a second. Are we going to have? Yeah, there's going to be a McLean's going to get a power play. I'm not sure what the call is. Are they going to give a 2+10? Could have been head contact on a hit. No, they are not. So it's going to be a 2-minute power play for McLean. Not sure what the call was. It didn't look like anything happened, but the ref saw something that I didn't. Either way, Flint Hill won the faceoff. They sent down McLean, now rushing back. Tommy Malloy looking, sends it. Now back for Jordan Bloom. That was Jordan Bloom who had possession, and he has it behind the net. Now Dev DeVoyne, Dev looking. Now out front and deflected away and send it for Colton Hoipel. No good anyways, and McLean will take over. Dev looking. Now looking again. Dev across the line, and that one just a hair offsides. Jordan Bloom, but definitely looked like it was offsides. So it'll come out of the face out of the puck. It'll come out of the zone. The face off. It'll be on the far near side towards us, all the way in front of the bench of the Flint Hill Huskies. Face off one, a minute to go. McLean, 13 shots, just no goals. Need to find a way. Sam Silverman draw pass to Fip Wah. Face the shot, back to a point. That was probably a better idea than taking a bad angle shot. Trying to deflect it on goal. Sam Silverman and nobody home as he tries a centering feed. Nobody in front of the net for Highlanders. He was kind of surprised about that. Now Fip Wah with a huge shot and a pad save. Trying to go five hole. Oh, in discussions with the team, they said that Morse could be beat five hole, which refers to between the pads. That one, he closed down. Carter Gross looking, and then they give it right up. Trying to a little move from line strike. Either way, McLean does have possession. Can't be careless now here where Tom Malloy with a shot, no good. And McLean, you're going to have to get some better looks if they want to do anything. Now the Fip Wah looking, beats it over. Nice look out in front, looking for Debbie Starr! No, Tommy Malloy scores, and either way, McLean has the lead. It's 1-0 on a great pass by Fip Wah. Gets it to Tommy Malloy, and it's 1-0 McLean. Both players are wearing red helmets, so it's just a little bit confusing. So Tommy Malloy puts the Highlanders on the board, and it's 1-0 McLean. A power play goal. And now McLean finally is through after 16 shots. Base off one, Flint Hill, and a nice hit put on by Hoipel. Colton, solid, and they'll try and move it out. Jordan Bloom gets ahead. Devoyne, Dev looking, trying to find Hoipel. What a play, but it's sticked away at the last second. Played in, and a delayed offsides, and Flint Hill will move it. Man, what a play to get it to Hoipel from Devoyne. He recognized he didn't have the shot, tried to backhand it, but no good. Dev, behind the net, Dev. Trying to break it out, 9:39 to go in the second. Long pass to Hoipel. Hoipel trying to cut through the slot. Looking, still looking. Going right half. Well, back to the point, but Evan Hart will take ahead. But a good play by Phipps, Aiden Phipps, to backhand it, but everything then ends up offsides. 9:22 to go. Tommy Malloy with a sneaky little goal, forehand, backhand, hand dangle on the goalie, cutting out in front from the right side. That's made it 1-0 McLean. Now, deflected shot tried by Flint Hill, ends up going behind the net and played up for Misselfelt. Now Hecker, Jack Hecker versus speed across the line. He'll go wide, stops. Right wing corner, sending it behind the net. David Todd out front trying to find Misselfelt, but Jack Hecker trying to get it back. But ultimately, it's played up by Flint Hill, but then played back by McLean. Right wing corner, looking for it there. And now the puck coming out front, trying a pass. David Todd, another terrific pass. Now another shot, and that deflected wide off for somebody in front. And out of the zone and down for an icing. 8:29 to go, 1-0 McLean. McLean has 17 shots to none for Flint Hill. And that is definitely remarkable. Flint Hill has had some chances, but for the most part, McLean has been better. And if Flint Hill does have a shot that I am not alluding to, it's probably either one or two. McLean definitely very good defense. They just need to find a better way on offense. Discussion. Well, either way, we're going to have this face-off, and it'll be Sam Silverman to take it. One by Flint Hope. Elias strike all up. Play game to left wing corner. Take that. Now cross for Fipwa. Fipwa shot trying to find strike. Oh, what a great idea by Fipwa there, man. What great hockey skills he has tonight. Fipwa just muscling his man off the puck. Here he'll go to a. He tried to go to the slot. No good. Find Carr Gross. Carr Gross trying to put on net. It finds Fipwa once again. Right wing half wall. Fipwa trying to play out front. Line strike. Thaw about the centering. Pass back to Fip. Won't work across for Gross. Gross. He'll just fire it back in behind the net. Fipwa muscling his man. And McLean's getting some good ice time using all the position. Carr Gross. What a shot. Oh, and that's deflected wide off of somebody out in front. Flint Hill finally playing it back. Foot race. Fitzgerald, number 19, giving up on it. He's pretty tired, though. Excuse me, that would be Ebenhart. Either way, he's played the fifth. Fifth, looking. Fifth walk. Oh, nice little bounce. That's going to the center of the ice. Ice with a shot in that one. Only finding netting. Missing by about a mile. Although they give Fifth credit, he's been solid in this game. Just needs to find better scoring opportunities. Although, yes, created some good scoring opportunities for his teammates trying to get the give and go working down low. We saw that with David Todd as well. Either way, it's with 7:13 to go, it's still a 1-0 game. McLean wins the faceoff. Now Dev looking. Dev playing it behind the net. Dev, number 80. Playing it, trying to get the Colt Hoipel canceled out, but Bloom and Jordan Bloom having it. Now across, Dev looking, shot, take it all! A save made, and Colton Hoipel with a terrific screen out in front. Trying to giving it to Jordan Bloom. Jordan Bloom now walks it back, cycle on, trying to feed for Jordan Bloom, and that one sent towards the net. Was able to get the shot off. A good cycle along the left wing wall for McLean on the far side. 6:31 to go, still 1-0 McLean. This game is game unless McLean can really put the pressure on where we probably will go the distance. Jay Barnett to take this face off with number 50 for the Huskies. Now back to point with a shot from Phipps, and that one no good. Now Brasciutti trying to work it, going to a front. Jack Hecker sticked away, and they'll move it up ahead, trying to get the long piece feed for Ebenhart. Ebenhart stops, waits, trying to go to center, looking, and then couldn't play it off. And either way, McLean will have it. Bad breakout procedures, but a nice hit put on, allowing Jack Hecker to scoot his way up, and he'll dump it in, but only finding finding some six of the Huskies. Number 10, that's Stewart. Stewart across, and he's played all the puck. Nice hit by Brasciutti. McLean behind their own net. Now up to Jack Hecker. Hecker, Jake Barnett. Jay Barnett having missile foul. Jay Barnett can't take handle in, but Jack Hecker is right there to pick the puck up anyway. Now gets to Jay Barnett. A shot set. Oh, man. Jay Barnett robbed out in front from the slot. My goodness. Now Ebenhart back the other way, trying to go to the net. Good job by Carter Gross feeding him off the puck. Carter Gross now with some space. Carter Gross. Gross trying to get it in, taking a couple of wax with his stick, and it's sent out the center where Fipwa will have it. Harassed by some player, Flint Hill players, now across the line. Hoipel trying to go to net, and that one doesn't work. Fipwa now circling top of the slot, now with a shot, that one going wide and above the net. Puck bow behind the net, sent left wing corner. Fipwa, if her ass enough, comes back to a point, it's sent back. Fipwa right wing corner. Fifth trying to set something up. Fifth sends it to a point. Good idea. Gross across. Tom Malloy, he'll just send it down. McLean once again having good ice time in their offensive zone. This is good. Fifth trying to go to the net. Fifth take it down. No penalty called. No trips, says the referee. Now Hoipo has shot, and that one goes wide. And Sam Superman, he scored! It was deflected, and I believe Fifth got it. Or no, they're saying Sam Superman put it in. Fifth might have deflected it, but it doesn't matter, and it's 2-0 McLean. Ray out in front on the right side, and McLean finally having some better life here with 19 shots on board and with 4:08 to go. It's 2-0 Highlanders. McLean just with great possession time was able to get in, and Sam Silverman just able to put it in 5-0, I believe, across the sliding goaltender for Morse. And either way, it's a 1-0 McLean lead. And by the way, Tori Yoon, McLean goalie, no shots on the scoreboard to reflect. I mean, he's been kept cold by Highlanders because McLean's really doing such a good job. Now, We do apologize for that. It was a little bit network technical issues. It's 2-0 McLean, 2:14 to go in the second. As a puck fired in, deflect behind the net. For a second, we thought it was in. Now Phipps back looking. Now Malloy trying to stick handle a crazy play. And now they're going to say that the play was offside, I do believe. And a breakaway whistle down. That was number 15 for Flint Hill. That would be Spivey. Face off inside of the McLean zone. Players are changing. And the whistle was because McLean's going to have a power play. I did not see what was the issue, but that is, I believe, the third for McLean. Now the faceoff will end up coming outside the zone, but McLean a big chance to really put the coffin in. They have 19 shots and 2 goals. 3 forwards, 2 D, and the refs trying to tell the players what's going on, but quick win for McLean going in with a shot. Oh, that's deflected. Colton Hoipel and Jordan Bloom went right to the net. Now DeVoyne with a shot, Dev, and that one deflected away. Back in the zone, and now taken for McLean. Dev looking. He'll have it. 1:39 to go. Now up here are the Colton Hoipel. Now back to Jordan Bloom. He tried to stick out through his man, won't work, and sent back. A nice little pass behind on the feed by Colton Hoipel. Now Phipps not doing the best job there as he gave the puck over, but either way, the intended pass goes right to Jordan Bloom. Bloom, right wing circle now coming to Malloy. Malloy almost gets the puck out. Not the best idea. Either way, falls to Phipps. Phipps, less than a minute to go. 53 seconds going on the penalty. Just a couple seconds between the game clock and the penalty clock. McLean will have a couple extra seconds of power play time. 38 seconds go in the period. 2-0 McLean. Dev, trying to feed out front. Oh, couldn't connect quite with Jordan Bloom, who stops at the left wing half wall. He's taken down, moving in. It's Dev finding. Hoipel with a shot. Oh, my goodness, how did that not go? He had a wide open net. The shoot at it somehow. Morris, he either missed or Morris was able to make the save. 10 seconds to go. And then deflected. Number 99 for Flint Hill will fire it back in. That is Rob Fitzgerald, and that will do it for a second period. We do apologize if our mic was turned off for a little bit. I did not realize that. Hopefully, you are not missing too much of the game. Either way, at the end of the second period, it's McLean Highlanders 2-2 in the Flint Hill Huskies 0. You're listening to McLean Broadcast Network. We will be back in just a second. We'll mute our mics for now. Start of the third period back with you here 50 minutes on the clock here on the McLean Broadcast Network. McLean 2-0 over the Flint Hill Huskies, although it's been all McLean. No shots recorded on the scoreboard for the Flint Hill Huskies, and this could go down as a no-shot shutout for Tory Union. I'm sure that would be very interesting, but I don't know if that's ever happened. And if that is the case, I don't know, that could set a, well, I'm sure not, but that's definitely one that I'm sure the local press might want to think up on. Anyway, start of the third period, 4:45 to go in the third period, 14:45, excuse me. The puck taken along the near boards, and Fipois carries in. Fipois looking right in the feet. He finds Sam Silver. A shot! Oh, and that just missed. Why, what a feed by Fipois. He has it back. Fipois looking. Toe drags. Shoots it. Deflected wide. Up high. I'm not sure if Morris got a piece of that. Now behind the net. By the way, did we mention now out front? We'll get to that thought in a second. Now a shot coming in. Oh! And Morris had to get that out of midair. So deflected shot from Linus Stroik. Excuse me. Came in. Did we mention that if McLean is able to keep the lead for the next 14:06, they will win the division, back-to-back division championships for McLean. If they can do so, they won it last year and fell in the first round. Second round, they got a first round bye. They lost to a very good broad run team. And did I mention with a better record than them? Smash down. That's going to be an icing. Flint Hill, that connection did not work. At least the pass did not. 20 shots for Highlanders, 13:58 to go. Still no shots for the Huskies as of yet in this game. At least recorded. McLean is home team. trying to keep it in is Mitchell Phelps. Ends up going out of the zone, but with enough time for reinforcements to come back, David Todd dumps it in, only finds the skates of a Flint Hill player, and then sent back. Remember, send the head to Ebenhart. Ebenhart circling back in. Now, still trying to get it out. Good presence by the Highlanders. Ross trying to move it. He finally does, only finding Ebenhart off of the deflection by Jack Hecker. Still trying to get out. My goodness, the Highlanders are playing good. Keeping it in. Now, Mitchell fell, trying to get by a couple men, but David Todd ended up slowing him up. Either way, the putt's still in the Flint Hill zone, and now finally out. Tommy Malloy, who had the first goal of this game, he couldn't find it, and a little risky dangle. You always don't want that. Either way, McLean moving ahead with, going to the net. So Jordan Bloom took the puck up, fed it, trying to feed it to Colton Hoipel, and it all ended up and out in front of the net and a faceoff. Faceoff coming for McLean. They win it cleanly. Dev with a shot. That's a flat out. Out for rebound. Oh, winner. Terrific save on Colton Hoipel by Morse. A point blank stop. Now behind the net. Jordan Bloom looking. And now Colton Hoipel. He gets spear off the puck. And either way, McLean still with puck possession in their own zone with 12:15 to go. Jordan Bloom, looking out in front. Jordan trying to find Hoipel, a shot off the inside of the post. Another chance out in front, and that scurries wide off of the toe of Morse. My goodness, Morse, the only one. 24 shots, 2 goals. He's the only player keeping Flint Hill in the game right now as the play comes back on Tori Yoon. McLean now take it up. Colton Hoipel spear off the puck by number 55. That'll be Ross and sent back behind 77. Fitzgerald, one of the Fitzgerald brothers, will take it either way. But then McLean up with Jordan Bloom. Bloom with some speed trying to go to the net. Net deflected off by his man looking for reinforcements. He'll just try to tally behind, finding Dev. Dev left. Left wing Dev behind the net now with is Hoipel. Hoipel trying to find Bloom behind the net. Below the goal line, left wing corner, now back and out of the zone, and now as they came out, they came back, a whistle coming. And I'm not sure. They're talking about something. Either way, the play stopped. Now, no penalty is going to come of this. And a face-off right at center ice. Face-off one. Silverman with a little bit of high stick and a little bit of puck work there. There with 10:44 to go in this game. The fans reacting kindly to it. Everhart now with it. Lost it but got it back. Oh, move in. Played off the puck by Fipwat. The puck anyways will come behind the net and right wing corner. 10:27 to go in the third period. 2-0 McLean. Now Sam Silverman. The Fipwat trying to centering feed. No good. And it'll only find Flint Hill Sweaters. Good job there, but taken down was Aiden Phipps, and McLean's gonna get a power play. It was Aiden Phipps being taken down.
Let's play the game. Come on.
Aiden Phipps was taken down, and well, they're not going to call a penalty. I thought they would. He was taken down with what looked to be a hook, but no call by the referees, just a whistle either way. It's still a 2-0 game, and McLean Wow. Well, missile, either way, missile foul trying to go to the net won't work. And by the way, there's been a shot recorded on Tori Yoon either way. Now trying to come out. Now Jack Hecker, ooh, and that almost went through. And here come the Huskies. 2-on-2 into the zone. Good job by Gross. Connor Gross able to spear that one away. And either way, it doesn't matter. Carter Gross, excuse me. McLean back into their offensive zone. Very familiar territory, trying to go to the net. Oh, I say rebound. Oh, my goodness. And it won't work. And then Jay Barnett trying to spear that puck free, and he just got met by about three or four Flint Hill players, and Jay Barnett slow to his feet. And he just got speared hard by about four Flint Hill players. He's up on his feet, and that's good news. From what I can tell, Chris Cardwell has not come back from the dressing room, and he was injured earlier in this game. Unfortunately, he's yet to return, so you don't want another injury. And you hope he's okay. Faceoff one, Aiden Phipps, and now Verschuti got a huge hit, and here comes Flint Hill. Hill, number 18, working, trying to go around his man, and Phipps with a nice poke check there. And either way, McLean coming back. Jordan Bloom across the line. Jordan Bloom with a shot. Oh, and that didn't work. Now back. And it'll be taken ahead by Flint Hill. 8:37 to go. Go 26 shots for McLean. They say one shot for the Huskies. But I did not recall it. It may still be that the zero save shutout is alive. I do not know. Now back to Devon. Oh, man. And that one shot deflected and ran to Morris's red basket and into his glove. Right between on the chest. Ended up grabbing his glove and hauling that one in. 8:20 to go. 2-0 McLean. Still looking for a third goal. That'll be nice. Bipwah, big shot coming an easy pass save by Morse. Left wing corner, and now Bipwah behind the net, muscling another high one. Bipwah gives some high strikes and then take it down, and a penalty coming up on Bershuti. Sue him on Bershuti. He's going to get the 2 men for a trip. He's arguing his case, but Flint Hill's going to go to a power play. And all this craziness with 7:57 to go. And do remember, if McLean wins this game, they are Adams Division champions. What a moment that would be. If they can get one more goal, that would be pretty amazing. Now, there's only one shot recorded for Tori Yunus. McLean places one down Bipwah chasing, and that means he's a little cold, and that could be bad at this point. You're Flint Hill. You need a goal now, and you need some shots because you've had an effectively none. Flint Hill able to keep in. Backhander fighting Fitzgerald. Gerald number 99. That's Robert, one of the Fitzgerald brothers, and McLean able to clear back down. 7:23 to go in the third period. 2-0 McLean. All McLean so far, except on the goals where it's closer than actually probably is. Although McLean has only gotten 28 shots, and you wonder, well, maybe it should be more. Maybe another couple goals either way since play back down. It's still 2-0. 1 minute to go in the penalty to Verschuti. That's all right. And now they'll move ahead. Evan Hart, he speared off the puck, trying to play back and out of the zone for Bipwah. Send puck sent behind the net for the goalie, and it's sent back out. And now up ahead, Evan Hart with some speed trying to go to center. A trailer coming in with a shot, and that one just the wide, high and wide of the net. You need to get it back on. Your Jack Hecker comes the other way. You need to get a shot on net in that case. And unfortunately, here with 12 seconds to go in the penalty kill power play, I mean, Flint Hills had nothing. And here's a shot that comes in. So that should be another shot. And either way, now officially, as the penalty expires, and Flint Hills keeps it in. Now going to the net. My goodness, nobody there. And oh man, that could have been deadly. They just played to the net. Number 39 standing in front for Flint Hill. And then Malloy just stays his man down with a huge, excuse me, number 38. Hey, now a big lead pass for Jordan Bloom. Jordan Bloom trying to go in, and that one deflected to the right wing, left wing corner, and behind. That would have been deadly. McLean's made some bad mistakes, although they played pretty decently. You just wonder if they can get some more goals. It's only going to get harder in the playoffs. 5:09 to go. If they can survive without giving up two goals, they're division champions. Another goal would definitely put this one on ice with only three shots for, and now Evan Hart trying to go to a net. That won't work, and it's cut out in front. McLean behind their own net, trying to break it out, looking up. Penalty has expired. Hey, Phipps trying to cut to the net, deflected off left wing corner right now. They may be just trying to waste some time. Phipps, one-on-one battle with number 77. Still in the corner now. Dev brings up. Dev looking, taken out from behind. No call. Either way, for Flint Hills, it's deflected out. They have not been able to manufacture their own luck. And then a pass and deflected. Either way, finds McLean players. Malloy gets hit hard and then sent that down. Either way, Fifth yard away with a shot and right to the chest. And then Malloy with an expert shot, number 77. And you don't need this right now. Now, and I believe Phipps trying to get his man off, taking a couple extra shots at number 23, I believe it is, for Flint Hill. I do not have a number for him. 3:54 to go here in the third period. It's looking more and more likely that McLean will clinch a division championship tonight, and doing so will clinch a first round bye. Now here, Wall with a shot, and a save made by Morse. Fip Wall with a big rocket trying to go five hole. That one did not work. Morse has been solid in this game, stopping 28 out of 30 shots. He's faced, and if you had three stars of the game, he would definitely be one of them, although it's seeming more like a losing effort. Fip Wah trying to play his man off the puck. Either way, he will gain possession. Fip Wah going to the slot. Fip Wah, nice move right wing. Circle, one shot, save, rebound, and no goal as the puck was loose out in front of him. Running a quick whistle, and fresh bodies will come over. The puck came, I believe, into the net. No, that's because the net was dislodged. That's why the whistle blew. A McLean player must have taken it off because there's no penalty. Or at least it was not intentional. 3:34 to go. 31 shots for the Highlanders. Only three for the away visiting Flint Hill Huskies. I mean, just a dominant in many ways for the Highlanders here as they break it out. And then it'll come back in, number 39 chasing for the Huskies. Excuse me, number 99 chasing for the Huskies. That would be Robert Fitzgerald. Now McLean break it up. Dev moving in. Left wing. Dev going to the net. Dev going to net behind. Trying to beat out in front. And it'll be covered by Morse with 3:05 to go. Face off, won by Flint Hill. They'll send her around. Aiden Phipps now trying to feed it to Jay Barnett down the left wing corner, but they give it up. Now coming in out in front, but it's an offsides as just Evan Hart got in and before the puck. Colton Hoipel going around. Colton Hoipel again moving at left wing circle. Spins off, 2:38 to go. Back now to Phipps, and then trying to send it to Dev. No good was there. He's harassing his man as a Flint Hill player was cherry picking right there. But in good cell, they have yet to really get that many good opportunities. They've got it covered now. Flint, oh, goal! And Jay Barnett could put Omar feet out in front, and he just missed. He had a wide open net. Now Evan Hart coming the other way. Evan Hart played off fiercely by Phipps in a good way. So that could have been bad. Now Dev DuVoyne gonna play it in, and they had an empty net. I did not see the goalie, and McLean has put the game on ice. I did not see them vacate the net. I was watching the action go the other way, and this is a goal, and this will definitely put the game on ice. McLean, congratulations, is going to win the hockey game. Now a puck's coming. Somebody got their first. I'm not sure who scored either way. Kind of came in surprise. 1:53 to go. Flint Hill, well, they're just going to have to watch this game end here. It's across for Heckman, a shot coming in. Morse, who's played terrific, allowing two goals on 33 shots. The third goal, well, guess you count against him. But his team hasn't been able to back him up tonight. Behind Flint Hill's net, they'll try to move it out. And now coming to the left wing boards, and Evan Hart moving it ahead. It just sent that down. Carter Gross, 1:12 to go. McLean just playing loose and relaxed here. The chance came out to David, and as trying to play him off the puck, he was not trying to get it back. Now Jack Heckman coming out in front, ooh, and he couldn't put it home. There's, he's deflected off the ice, off of the puck as the puck comes out. It's our left, 46 seconds to go in the game. Carter Gross, 40 seconds to go. Puck coming back. McLean just wanting to end this. 33 seconds now going to the net for missile foul. Trying to put it home, and they do! A goal! Missile foul on the back end, and it's 4-0 McLean. What a nice goal by Misselfeld, taking the puck to the net. And McLean now can definitely start the celebration. McLean looking, just trying to end this game at this point. 28 seconds to go. Congratulations to 2015-2016 McLean Highlanders. They are Adams Division champions for only the fourth time in their history, and for the second time, it's back-to-back. Evan Hart trying one last chance to break the shutout. He goes to the net, and he's played down a hard lick, and then comes out 8 seconds to go. Played off the puck. Out in front, ladies and gentlemen, your McLean Highlanders are division champions. They are Adams Division champions, and they clinch a first round bye. They have finally clinched that division. They're 8-0. McLean now looking for that second seed. A 4-0 victory against the Flint Hill Huskies. Final shot goes 35-4, McLean dominating fashion. Morse, the only one really to keep this game alive for the Huskies. Really nothing going for Flint Hill. For everybody on the McLean Broadcast Network, I am Matthew Zwirb saying so long. We will see you probably next year at Skate Quest when the playoffs start. The final score, McLean, 4-0, nothing. You've been listening to a presentation of McLean Broadcast Network.